Today, we are going to discuss another reinforcement learning algorithm called Q-learning. Q-learning is the root of many successful reinforcement learning algorithms like deep Q-learning, deep deterministic policy gradient, and we are going to discuss these algorithms in our upcoming videos. If you haven't already subscribed to my channel, then please do it right now for detailed explanation on various topics related to AI. Before going into the details, let's have a quick intro of the topic for our new viewers. Have you ever seen a dog trainer giving some food to the dog for every successful command? Well, that food is a reward to the brain saying, well done, you are going in the right direction. Our brain craves rewards, something that gives it happiness. And our brain tries to do those things again and again that gives it even more rewards. Can we replicate this type of training in our robots so that they crave rewards or appreciations like we do? So that they can learn new skills by themselves, like a dog maybe? The answer is yes, this type of autonomous learning is called reinforcement learning. In this video, we are going to talk about such a reinforcement learning algorithm called Q-learning. Using Q-learning, a reinforcement learning agent tries to figure out the quality of its action based on the rewards it receives, so that it can decide which actions to perform in sequence to get maximum reward in the long term. Let's develop a quick intuition about Q-learning. Suppose this arm has to train itself to reach the target location with minimum number of steps. Let's assume that the arm receives a reward based on its distance from the goal. The smaller the distance, the higher the reward. The state of the arm can be defined as its joint angles. Since we are using a kinematic arm, so we are not considering any inertia. So our state can be defined fully using the joint angles. For instance, the current state of the arm can be written as a tuple of two values like 30 degrees and 30 degrees. Now, at this state, let's assume that the arm has two options. It can apply action positive 5 degrees or negative 5 degrees displacement to both the joints. Now you tell me, which action is better for the arm to achieve the goal? It is positive 5 action or negative 5 action to the both joints? Exactly, it is the positive 5 actions to the both joints. Because it will take the arm a bit closer to the target and give higher rewards in the long term if it decides the future actions also rationally. In terms of Q values, we can say that positive 5 action has higher value compared to negative 5 actions at the current state of 30 degrees of the arm. Q-learning attempts to figure out or estimate these values for all the possible actions for all the possible states so that the robot can decide optimally which action is the best to take at any state depending upon the goal. Once the Q values are estimated, the arm can simply follow the action at any state that has highest Q value. Now in this case, the rule that decides a particular action based on the Q values is called a policy. For instance, a greedy policy always selects the action having the highest Q value at any state. Similarly, an epsilon greedy policy will select most of the time the highest Q value action, but sometimes selects any action randomly with a small probability epsilon. On the other hand, a fully random policy doesn't care about the Q values. It selects any action randomly at any state. I think basics are done now, so let's dive deeper into the game. The formal definition of a Q value at any state S and for any action A corresponding to any policy pi is the expected return received by the agent if it applies action A first and then it follows the policy. So it's a complicated statement. So the agent has to apply an action A first in state S, and then onwards it has to follow the policy pi. Okay, and doing so repeatedly, whatever rewards it gets, long-term rewards it gets, the expectation of that is called the Q value of the state and action pair. Now the question is how a robot or an agent autonomously figure out these optimal Q values. Here comes the Q learning update rule. The agent or the robot executes actions on the states it encounters using a behavior policy. and after it sees the consequence of an action, it updates the Q value of the action for the previous state. A behavior policy is any policy that allows the agent to explore wide range of actions for a wide range of states. For instance, we can use an epsilon greedy policy like this. As you can see, for any state S, this policy will tell the agent to perform mostly the action having maximum Q value as I explained before. But sometimes with a small probability epsilon, it will tell the agent to perform any random action. Because of these random actions, the agent will not execute the same action sequence again and again because it has to explore all the states, all the actions as widely as possible to estimate the Q values for all the possible state action pairs, right? Now, I guess we have enough knowledge about the background to talk about the update rule. Suppose at any state S, the agent executes an action A. As a consequence, it moves to the state S dash and receive a reward R. Then Q learning updates the Q value of the previous state like this. In this expression, this is called the target Q value for the previous state. As you can see, the old Q value of the previous state is updated towards a fully greedy policy, right? Because unlike SARSA algorithm that we explained in the previous video, here we consider the Q value that is maximum in the next state. While in SARSA, we consider the Q value for the action that we actually take in the next state. Thus, Q learning is called off policy algorithm. We update the Q values towards the greedy target policy and not towards the policy that we are actually following. Here is the full Q learning algorithm. First, we initialize the Q table with some arbitrary values for all the state action pairs. Then we iterate for n episodes. At each episode, we start from the initial state and we perform k steps if we do not encounter the terminal state. At any state S, first we query the epsilon greedy policy A. Then we apply the action and observe the reward and the next state S dash. Then we update the old Q value for the previous state in the Q table using the Q learning update rule. Now let's apply the Q learning algorithm on a 2 degree of freedom kinematic arm and see how it learns. The state of the arm can be defined, as I explained before, by a vector of its joint angles. The action is a vector containing positive or negative 5 degree displacement of the joints. And the goal of the arm is to learn to reach this target as quickly as possible. So we give reward which is like inversely proportional to the distance, like we discussed before. Since Q learning requires discrete states, we discretize the states of the arm by an interval of 10 degrees. As you can see, the arm has started exploring with an epsilon greedy policy. Since initially we do not have a good estimate of the Q values, the arm is moving mostly here and there without any significant reward collection. While it is learning, let's have a quick look at the Python code that I have written for this. I made it as short as possible and didn't use any additional functions in the algorithm. So you can clearly see the sections of the Q learning algorithm in the code. Here, we first initialize the Q table. In our case, the Q table is a Python dictionary with the state action vector as the keys for that table. We are setting zero values initially. And using Q learning, the arm will update these values towards the actual Q values in an iterative manner. Then we initialize the environment here. And then this is the main learning loop. We iterate for 2000 episodes because we assume that by 2000 episodes, we'll have a good estimate of the true Q values. And then here we start the 40 steps long episodes. In every step, we get the action using our epsilon greedy policy. And then we execute the action. In the next state, we query the maximum Q value from the table and we update the Q value of the action in the previous state. After 200 episodes, we can see that the arm is pretty much consistent and the arm is going to the target position every time. And that's it, seems working. So Q learning is good, but the thing is it doesn't work for continuous state system. Moreover, it can update only Q values for those states and action that it has experienced. It cannot update the Q values for those states and those actions it has never seen during the exploration process. In the next video, we'll discuss another reinforcement learning algorithm called deep Q learning, which can deal with continuous state space. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to get notified about my upcoming videos.